Hi folks, a bit of Saunders Waterford cold press paper. I'll my brushing on here. My large hake was, hemorrhaging hairs. So my friend Glenn from Hawaii contacted Jackson's in London, Jackson's Art, who sent me a lovely brand new hake for that. Look at that. So, Glenn, ever in your debt, thank you very, very much. It's a very kind of you this time of the year, and I do really appreciate it. So, with you in mind, we'll do a bit of a snow scene. I don't know if you get any snow out in Hawaii, but we had a lot. On Sunday evening, and then it snowed up everything for 6 days, 5 or 6 days, and we weren't able to do our weekly bike ride. When did the snow come? Saturday night, Sunday. Sunday night, it's Wednesday now. I've lost a week, I think. The snow came, and it was on the ground for quite a long time, a few days. And then it went overnight, and the temperature rose to about 10, 11 degrees. I'm talking about London here. But it was so freezing cold, so we couldn't go on that bike ride. But we managed yesterday, and that was lovely. So, going to put a sky in. I'm going to use a bit of a. Let's try a bit of burnt sienna. And a bit of ultramarine. I usually use Payne's grey, but we'll try this. You get a sort of a bluey grey, which is very nice. So. Just let that sort of mould in. It's been wetting wet. This is beautiful paper. Right, so now we're going to paint wetting wet. I wanted to get get some trees in there, so the same sort of colour, a bit heavier. A bit darker than that. A bit deeper blue. So while the paper's wet, you can sort of do a lot of things with it. That's when it starts to dry, there's a problem. Thank you. bit dark, are you? Good way of painting grasses, just push the hake. I did see a demonstration showing this. Okay, let's get a card, just take some this paper doesn't really like being scraped out, but we could go over these later when they dry and just reinstate them. Right, now, with that medium hake, I'm going to just put in some darker notes. I'm even using two colours with this. Too wet. The thing is, I over the many years I've been doing this, I have great difficulty now in painting original stuff or repeating myself from what I've done in the past. We'll scrape that out there, let's just get that bit wet. So some brushes and stuff in there. Some warmer colours. Right, so let's get some darker stuff in there. Be careful if it goes, if it paints, if your paper's too wet, you do this, as it's drying, for the sake, you could have a real disaster on your hands. Alright, let's try it. I'm going to use a bit of gouache on this one. Right, I'll give that a bit of a dry, so take your headphones off. Ready? Go. Just pull the paper straight, pull the kinks out of the paper. Just keep it flat. See, there's no buckling in this. with this lovely paper. It's only 90 pound weight, but it packs a punch. Right, here we go. Well, let's get a bit of this dark colour here. Going off into the distance. Well, I'm going to use a bit of gouache. I'll put the gouache on my little table. Okay. Let's put some lighter colour on the tops of these things, these rocks. Right, now I put a, no, I know what I'm going to do. Just using these colours, these two colours. Let's say. It's amazing what you can do with two colours. Look over there, just coming up from behind that rock there. Thank you. for another block over the other side. Right, we've put a little couple of figures. I think we'll have red. We've got any red? Yeah, I've got some alizarin. A bit blue. Oh, that's a little bit of gouache here and there. A bit of paints here and there. So a little bit more texture in this distance, so just a bit of that blue and a bit of that. This is all one colour, or two colours, apart from those bits in there, but I think right. If I was to add another couple of colours to my palette, it would be cad red or a red, vermilion. Okay. going to rig her back. I want to just reinforce, strengthen this up a bit. So you get a good dye. You could use Payne's Grey, really blue, but you get a slightly different grey. Right, okay. Strengthen up these in here. Right, I'll put that amount. That's two I've done this morning. The first one was an abstract on a textured MDF, very limited colours. Just an experiment, really. But it's just another way of painting, which you can develop into all sorts of lovely things. Right, okay, well, there we are. Could have a couple of birds, couldn't we? A couple of birds. I don't reckon those figures are big enough. They're a bit out of scale. If you take them to the horizon, they're going to be like ants. So let's see if we can change those. Put a nice big red one. I'll put in a bit of white hats, white helmets. So wet, isn't it? Small heads. I might have to make them even bigger. That's right, hold on, headphones off, go. Right, okay, let's get some legs in. Thank you. Alaska, so I'll let that go. Right, thanks for watching, folks. I'll see you soon. Bye bye. Oh, it's just. Right, I'll get these uploaded for you. Bye for now.